what we have done earlier is we are using symbol. So you have C, you can use a minus symbol or this kind of symbol to end as the intersection, and this is the union, and this as the supplement, and some compare. And also we can use natural language names. So to, let's see, so my set 3 equal to this one. So we can use is my, that's right, is a little complex, is our method. So my set 2 dot intersection is my set 1. So let me print my set 3. What I will get? 2, 3, 4. So that is the same as intersection. But by, please be noticed here, the code in the book is a little error here. I may try to mention to the author on this. Either you can put here is 1 intersection with 2 or 2 intersection with 1. So that is vice versa. There's no difference. But this is 2, 2, 2 is not correct. Just bear in mind, it's a minor thing. And then this for the difference, so we can also use this print my. So difference has the direction. So we use my set 1 minus my set 2. So that will be the difference. Difference my set 2. So let's print. So you go to 1, 5. So what if we use another direction? So possible in Python, well, we don't see the difference. Let me see. So okay, so that is a set empty. So let's just have a look. It's, you have my set 2 is 2, 3, 4, and you minus my set 1. So you already minus this, and you minus more. So all the 2, 3, 4 are minors. So then that will be our empty. So that's same as if you again watch my OpenICAD the tutorial. That will be more the direct feeling when you do this 3D printing shape manipulate using the difference. So that has the actual is the you must have our direction who the difference to another one. So let me just give you our quick show. So if you got chance to use this OpenSCAD, that is a good the 3D modeling tool. So if I make our sphere, maybe I think it's R equal to 20. So then I don't need to save that. So you got our this sphere, and let's say I have our this cube, just as the size is 20. So I put this one. So now you can see you have our cube and the sphere. So let's try to show you is I use a difference command or the method, or you can see that function. So when I have this, you will see here. When I put this sphere first, cube second, that like is the, if we see sphere is a set 1, the cube is a set 2, so you use the set 1 divide this delete by set 2. That will be the difference if I put the cube. So maybe I did this copy. I make that translate on 40.0.0. So that translate into here. So now you get these two. So let's try to see. I put cube first and the sphere second. You can now compare. So that is the cube. So it's here. So if I put this cube, it's smaller. So that you can have a look. It's a difference. You don't see anything here. But if I put this sphere as transparent, you can see when I remove this cube, then this that have something is intersection. So inside this sphere, but in the second part is empty. So like this one, because cube is inside, inside the like set two inside set one. So if you want to use a set two to difference to set one, you will get empty. So that is the most 3D or the geometry, the explanation for this difference. So bear in mind, they have the which one is first, which one is second. It's a big difference. And then we also have this mindset. And another thing is, whenever you do this difference or uni or intersection, it's not change the original the set values unless you put that into our the another this assignment. So when I do this combination, so set one combined with set two, so let's remove those one comments. Then what do I got? Set one uni, set two. So maybe I need to finish the print. So you can see several times happened is you need to wait maybe half seconds to allow the save is completed. So when you press and it's still wrong and still in the saving processing, you get error. But actually here is that this is the final result for the uni. And then for this whether is or you can check one set is another site's subset, you can use the set 2 dot a subset is a boolean check. So my set 1, so let me comment this. So I also make 2. So whether set 1 is a subset of set 2. So you get is true and false because set 2 definitely is all inside the set 1, but the set 1 is beyond the set 2. So that's a very easy to understand. So let's comment this. We move to the next section. So add. I think if we combine those, it's just add. Later on, is we will have a delete. So delete elements in sets. So let's just try to make our set is the first. We will have our my set equal to our empty one, then my set dot add. So add is, if you dot use dot, you can check is those are the different method you can use. Or add, update, difference, update, remove, discard, clear. So we will use clear later on. So you add our watermelon, and then we print my set. I got a watermelon, so then let's keep adding those. So I add another watermelon, So, and I add our difference, let me say apple. So what happened in the second and the third? So you see here, if you try to add or duplicate all the element already in the existing set, then that will not change the set, because set is the store the key, so they will not store the duplication of the this element. So you through this three add, you only add two elements or two unique elements. And we can also use the update. Update is when we have our watermelon. Is the honey melon. So then print my set. You can see here, that's another way, so we can add the element, but again, watermelon is the duplicated, so you only get a total three, the unique, this kind of the sets. So now we have my size with three, the elements. So we can start to make our delete. So del data, we have met this before, so we just use my site already. So we have a pop, and then let's repop without any parameter. So I suppose it's they just pop one. So now you see here, they pop from the beginning. So, but the del data, so is the pop, but you see here is the misleading part is because it's randomly delete. So we cannot know which one is deleted, but we can print our del data. I use date. So data. So you can see now I delete apple. And maybe, yeah, when I run again, I delete honey melon, it's watermelon. So it looks like it's, they have just changing, and really is the it is the random. So using this random is not our good practice. We need to control which one we want to delete. So that will be the way is try not to use this pop without any this kind of the parameter. Once it's already pop two, any means you pop three times, then all the element randomly will be removed from your the sets. Then if you want to do the number fourth time is pop from an empty site, that will give you an error. So so that is the thing we need to have a look. And next is we will have this discard. See, so we still use our list. So let's comment this. And we made my dict. So this is our dictionary, not the it called this dict is a little misleading. So let's call that set. Okay, we got this, and let's print my set to ensure we create a correct one. Yes, and then we print again. It's just to keep the original random set the sequence. So discard. So through discard, you can make this key indicator. So now print my site. So I use a wrong name. So I call this my site, not my dict. So then I remove the Hami Melon. And the same is you can keep remove if you try to remove something is not in your the list, then you will get this kind of key error. So this one, so this line is also our issue. So it should not be put here. So I found these are the second arrow we'll mention as test. So maybe see if we put this called apple. I should get our key. Oh, so arrow. Oh, so discard doesn't give an arrow. So, but remove, you may get our arrow. So then let's just try to see like this. So if I comment my discard, now I use remove. So first remove honey melon, second remove something not exist. Let's compare. So first, oh, so that is my bad. So it should have both. So first, my set. My set is this one. What's the thing? So my set is not defined. My set dot remove. Line 2. So let me delete this one. So let's save completely. Then I go to save here. I also go to here. So you see, first line is my site print. Second line is my site remove honey melon. Then left peach and watermelon. The third one is remove apple, so it's got arrow. So for remove, you cannot remove something not existed, but for discard is okay. So you can remove that and try to remove, but they don't give you arrow. And similarly, it's like a list or a dictionary, the clear is the make that all the this element gone. So now I make not I keep using this one, and then let's print. You should get our empty. So you see here. So first we have these three element. Now it's gone. So that is quite direct. Let's comments. And there is also comments. Oh, we can leave that and we will close this. And we combine, talking about this 2.7 is the none. So none is our the type we took to represent nothing. So when we put that is, you already see like this one. So let's see now. Type is our set. It's a set, and when they say what are the noun, is you need to define explicitly that is noun. Then we can print type name and the name, so we can see what that means. So now you got our noun type, and this name's value is noun. And if I give this R123 again, so then if I put this, Now you can see it's getting an integer and with the value. So that's the non is our special data type we will mention, and we will try to use that during our practice later on. So until now, we have finished all these first three chapter under chapter 2, and all type of this the data in Python, and we will use the next video to talk about this variable type. And to do this copy, we have this light copy and deep copy. So we will try to recap what that means. See you then.